Yes. Please sit down. Nice to see you all. I understand that you're supposed to take a few minutes on under strict orders. And then I'll go over there and I understand we'll get a chance to greet each one of you individually and we'll get some pictures. Want to be able to identify you if you get in trouble down there. Mission to Grenada, led by Craig Nayland, the president of the Overseas Private Investment Corporation, by Shelley Winnick, the chairman of the International Committee of our Advisory Council on Private Sector Initiatives. You executives here will explore ways that private American investment can provide economic opportunity in Grenada. In the recent past, many viewed government is the only way to make friends overseas, but government can never make as many friends for America as the American people themselves can. So we've taken every opportunity to encourage private sector initiatives aimed at helping counter the need. You may have heard of the support American businesses already provided for Grenada. Many companies have shipped items from textbooks to first aid supplies for the Grenadian people. This mission represents another fine example of private sector initiatives to help Grenada. The firms taking part in the mission are experts in agriculture, construction, manufacturing, tourism, and technology, areas where Grenada has the greatest need. I understand that Grenadian business people are eager to meet all of you and to help plan ways private investment can provide the training and create the jobs, generate the revenue so important to building free enterprise. And I know they'll give special attention to the ways that we can make speedy improvements in the transportation and communications between our two countries. This investment mission reaffirms our commitment to helping the people of the Caribbean. It's time, just as Grenadians have begun again to dream of a free and prosperous society. By working to turn that dream into reality, the members of the mission, the people of Grenada, will be setting an example for nations throughout the Caribbean. And I can't resist now telling you a little story that I think will interest you. You know, Winston Churchill said back in the World War II times, some people may frown at this today, but I always have taken some pride in it. He made the remark that we, Americans, seem to be the only people who can laugh and fight at the same time. A lieutenant in the Marines who flies a Cobra was at Grenada and then went on with the continuance of that Beirut mission and is in Beirut. And he wrote a little item back to the Armed Forces Journal. And he said that he had noticed that every story dealing with the incident in Grenada either opened with or closed with the line that Grenada produced more nutmeg than any other place in the world. And he decided that the frequency of that was such that it must be a code. And he had broken the code. Number one, Grenada produces more nutmeg than any other place in the world. Number two, the Soviets and the Cubans are trying to take Grenada. Number three, you cannot make good eggnog without nutmeg. Number four, you cannot have Christmas without eggnog. Number five, the Soviets and the Cubans were trying to steal Christmas. Number six, we stopped them. Let me close by telling you something that I heard on television a couple of months back. John Adams, the Prime Minister of Barbados, was being interviewed. And the questioner wanted to know how firmly committed the Democratic Caribbean nations were to free elections. So he asked, if the Grenadian people should elect a Marxist government, would that be all right with you? And Prime Minister Adams answered, yes, it would be all right with me. But I'll tell you this, I am absolutely sure that the American people will elect a Marxist government before any island in the Eastern Mediterranean. So the people of Grenada and the Eastern Caribbean learned firsthand the value of freedom. And as our one free people to another, I think it's our duty to help ourselves. So I thank you and wish you great success on your mission. God bless all of you for doing what you're doing. So now I understand I'm supposed to go and stand by the door there and get a chance to say hello to you.
Mr. President, may I just comment that all of us Americans, and I guess the whole world, have greatly admired the difficult decision you made regarding the rescue mission to Grenada. And we're undertaking this mission today to fulfill your dream of making Grenada a bastion of democracy. I can assure you we'll do our best. We'll try to.
Well, I assure you, all that fuss about it, not making the press about it, and that commando operation, I've squared that with them. I've told them that the next time anything like that happens, they will be in the very front of the skin divers go up to the river up there, Columbia, California, and dive on weekends. And then there are little jewelry shops set up along the shore there, and they take in the nuggets that they find out there in the river, the Tuolumne River. And it was while I was governor, one of them found this. It's that shape. That's the way it came out of the river. It was a gold nugget. But
I mean, it looks like California.
It is really the shape of California. And for you to think it was, that's the first time that anyone's ever looked and actually seen that resemblance. But it was just out of the river, fresh nugget there. Well, these are just souvenir pins with the presidential crest on them, sir.
Thank you.
Don't forget that you were here. Well, and congratulations to you both.
Thank you. It's our pleasure meeting you. Thank you for taking the time to see us.
May I say, it's redundant, I know, but may I say, it's my pleasure.
Oh! Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And again, thanks for
you. Thank you. Oh, it's my pleasure.
Mr. President, may I present the Ambassador of Guinea, Ambassador Triana.
Ambassador, how do you do?
Madam Diaba, no. President of the United States.
These are the four daughters. But this is
Fatimata. No.
You and I will go over in front of the fireplace with the picture. And then you will all come in.
I have the honor to give you my letters of credence from President Secretary.
Well, thank you very much, and please return a greeting to the President. A year and a half ago, he was here in this office. We had a nice visit, and incidentally,
our sympathy to all the victims of the recent earthquake. We hope we'll be able to be of help.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. And on the beginning of this new year, I would like to express to you on behalf of President Sekou Touré his warmest best wishes for your good health and for your longevity, as well as his good wishes for the well-being of the people of the United States. And he's also asked me to tell you how very anxious he is to strengthen the ties of cooperation and friendship between the United States and Guinea.
Well, we share that desire.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Voilà des bonbons que le président veut vous présenter. Ce sont les bonbons préférés du président.
Well, thank you very much and welcome.
Merci et soyez les bienvenus. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Right. You'll be very happy.
Et j'espère que vous serez très heureux.
Merci.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Merci beaucoup.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Jørgensen and Denmark.
First of all, the Queen, has asked me to convey the high regards. I have great inspiration with the Prime Minister. We were very pleased with the meeting he had with you in December last year when he was chairman of the EC. We have also appreciated very much the visit we had from Vice President.
I recall meeting her in 1972 when I was
there at the time, Mr. President, when you were the speaker at the Raven Festival in 72.
Yes.
And you also visited the Prime Minister at that time in his summer house in the northern part of Japan.
Yes.
Mr.
Jørgensen,
hello.
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 You and I will go over there for a photo, and then you will join us. For I remember that visit very well.
We were there. I was there at the Raven Festival in Raven Hills. And the Vice President, he was also the speaker this year at the Raven Hills. I think we are the only country outside the United States who are celebrating the 4th of July. I have my letter of guidance. My letter I called from a British officer and my mobile.
All right. 3 for 1. That's right. Why don't you come in now?
Thank you.
All right. Well, I hope you will enjoy your stay here.
Thank you very much, Mr. Bollinger. It was very much appreciated that you received our Prime Minister last year. It was very much appreciated that you Vice President even to Denmark. We have appreciated the close contact that has been between you and the United States and between Denmark and the United States at that time.
Well, we do too, and we're most appreciative of Denmark's strong stand on security matters.
Right.
All right.
Ambassador Mozambique, Ambassador Fedal.
Ambassador,
pleased to meet you.
Well, pleased to have you. I think they'd like us over there in front of the fire. Thank you very much. This is quite an occasion. You are the first ambassador from Mozambique, which is testimony now to our improved relations.
Yes.
Please express my thanks to President Michel.
I have been waiting for my president.
I appreciate his help on some of our dealings with Angola and Namibia. We're trying to accomplish there. All right, well, welcome. Pleased to have you here.
Hola, Mr. President.
Ambassador, welcome.
Senor Fasten.
Hello,
nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. And I'd like you to meet my son, Andres.
Hello there.
Fernando.
How are you?
And
we'll go over there for a picture, and then you will all come in and join us in the...
Thank you.
I have the honor to present to you my letters of credence, the letter of recall of my predecessor, and you get the best of this, you get through it.
Well, we are very pleased with all you've been doing regarding Contadora, and we're just hopeful together, all of us here, can bring some stability that I know your country wants very much, as well as the others down there.
We are committed to that process, and we hope that the results of this meeting right now are a step forward, and also in terms of what we are doing in our country in the electoral process, we hope to have some very good results.
We're looking forward to that.
Yes, very much.
Now, you all come in. We put them in the middle here between us.
All right.
One there.
Would you?
Yeah. Oh, thank you.
Jelly bean.